professional inpatient rehabilitation weekend engagement program. So we coordinated OT and PT students at Creighton to volunteer their services on the weekend, engaging with patients at Emmanuel Inpatient Rehabilitation Hospital and seeing if this could overall increase their patient satisfaction at the hospital, as well as reduce their feeling of loneliness and their feeling of boredom on the weekend. So to give you a little bit of background, the individuals that are in healthcare in this room are familiar with the triple aim, but to give you a little background on the foundation of our program, we really built this program to see how we can target the triple aim, or the currently used quadruple aim. So traditionally, healthcare utilizes the triple aim, focusing on enhancing patient experience, improving population health, and reducing overall costs. However, with this current model, we know that it increases burnout in caregivers, it reduces patient satisfaction, and overall increases healthcare costs. So there's been a recent shift, a paradigm shift, to the quadruple aim, which is the triple aim with an additional focus of improving the work life of healthcare providers. So reducing their burden of care, as well as increasing their satisfaction with their work. So we've really built our program to address and impact all aspects of the quadruple aim, and then we're researching to see how it does impact each of those areas. As we were doing our literature search before starting our research, we looked to see what the need is, or if there was a need for this type of program or type of service. And what we found is that there's an unmet social need during patient hospitalization, that these patients are experiencing loneliness and boredom, especially those that don't receive a lot of social support throughout the week. So we found that there is a need to have some type of engagement program. We also found that there are programs similar to this of individuals coming in to volunteer their time and work with patients in various ways, but none exactly like ours, including professional PT and OT students working with folks at an inpatient rehabilitation hospital. So there was a need, and so we developed this program to fit that need and see how it impacts patients as well as students. The title of our program, we called it For and With Others, and we based this upon the Jesuit values that Creighton instills with all the students and faculty members. As a Jesuit institution. And so we felt that the Jesuit value of women and men for and with others was really fitting for our program, as these students are volunteering their time to interact and engage with the patients at the inpatient rehab hospital. Our program was, again, designed to address all components of the quadruple aim. So seeing if we can enhance patient experience, improve overall population health, reduce healthcare costs by providing this free service to the organization, and improving work life of healthcare providers. So by providing services on Sunday, are we reducing some of the burden of the nursing staff, for example, on the weekend? This is just an image to depict all the potential stakeholders that could benefit from our program. So the students that participate in this volunteer engagement program might benefit from being exposed to an inpatient setting, getting exposure to interacting with individuals with a neurological dysfunction, getting practice and experience working on an interprofessional team, and then they also earn credit through their Creighton coursework by working or having interprofessional experience. The clinical organization benefits from having an extra service provided to the patients. It requires minimal time and resources to them. And then it also, our hope is that it eases the burden of the weekend staff. And then the patients, is what Sammy and I looked at, is it could benefit them from engagement during the weekends and at no added cost to them. So these are all potential stakeholders that could benefit, but Sammy and I are looking at one piece of the puzzle, seeing how our program specifically benefits the patients. In order for the program to be implemented throughout the year, it took a lot of coordination from Sammy and I and working with the therapists on the inpatient rehab team. So this just kind of just describes what our weekly protocol looked like. On Wednesday, Sammy and I would reach out to the therapy team to identify patients that would be appropriate for the program. And specifically, we were targeting patients that did not have a lot of social support or that could benefit from more social support. And then on Friday, we would complete communication sheets for the students. So this just included basic information about each of the patients so that the students could not only build the clinical picture and form their clinical reasoning, but also they had ideas of how to interact with these patients and of things to do. And this was really helpful for the therapist because they were able to carry over things they were working on during the week, during the weekend. And then on Sunday, two PT and OT student pairings would volunteer 2 hours of their time to come engage with these patients at the inpatient rehabilitation hospital. So they were doing things like any type of activities or games. They were able to help them with a home exercise program as long as it was already prescribed by the therapist, or even things as simple as conversing and just providing that social support to the patient. One thing to note, they were not able to provide any skill type of service, and that's how we were able to really implement this volunteer program without any supervision from a licensed therapist. And then after each interaction between the student and the patient, they were left a satisfaction survey to fill out regarding their volunteer experience as well as their overall hospital stay. And within 24 hours, Sammy and I collected that as part of our data analysis, or data collection and data analysis. So again, the aim of our study was to investigate the impact of the interprofessional program on overall patient satisfaction during their stay in the hospital. Before doing our research, we obtained Crate and IRB approval for this survey-based research. All of our participants were a sample of convenience. They were patients receiving services at Emmanuel Inpatient Rehabilitation Hospital. We had two groups. The intervention group were patients who participated in the Foreign with Others program. And to be included in this group, they were receiving services in the inpatient rehab hospital. They had limited family or social support. They would benefit from increased engagement. They were excluded from the research if they had substantial cognitive or communication speech deficits that limited their ability to fill out the satisfaction survey. So they were still able to participate in the program, they were just excluded from the research aspect of it. And then I just wanted to make a note that participants were allowed to be surveyed multiple times. So we did have three patient participants that participated and were surveyed more than one time. Our control group, which was our point of comparison, were randomly selected using a smartphone app. And these were patients on the inpatient rehabilitation unit who did not participate in the Foreign with Others program. So we had two groups to have a point of comparison. So for our outcome measures, each group received a satisfaction survey. The intervention group survey had 9 questions on it. And all right, let me back up real quick. So every time they participated in the program, they received a welcome letter introducing our survey or our research inviting them to participate in the research. And then they participated with this student, and then following that interaction, they were left a satisfaction survey if they agreed to participate in our research. And each of these surveys had 9 questions on them. Compared to our control group, which also received a satisfaction survey, but these only had 4 questions on them, and they were the same 4 questions that were asked on the intervention survey as well, so we could have that point of comparison. So looking at each of the surveys, you'll see that the intervention group had questions specifically related to their participation in the program, if they enjoyed the activities, enjoyed participating in the program. And then they had 2 open-ended questions. One was, what were the good things about the weekend program, and what ideas for improvement? And then 4 questions were asked to both groups regarding their satisfaction of their hospital stay. So their overall experience of their hospital stay, as well as how satisfied they are with their hospital stay, and then how often do they feel lonely or bored on the weekend, many times do they have visitors throughout the week? Both groups were very similar as far as demographics go. So for the intervention group, the average age was 67.1, ranging anywhere from 23 to 87 years old, compared to the control group where the average age was 66.7, ranging from 29 to 89. And for both groups, we had more males than females. In the intervention group, it was 24 males to 18 females, and in the control group, 32 males to 12 females. And that might just be the nature of the population that we were targeting or that we were working with. So with all of our data, we ran several tests to see if we could find any between group findings or within group findings. First, we took averages of responses and regarding loneliness and boredom. And the average response for the intervention group was that they disagreed. In the control group, the average response was they felt neutral. So this indicates that potentially by participating in the program, it might reduce their feelings of loneliness and boredom. And then when asked about if the hospital stay was exceptional, both groups agreed to this response or to this question. We looked at comparison between groups. We measured patient satisfaction of their hospital stay in using two different questions. One was a agree to disagree scale, 5-point scale, and one was a 10-point Likert scale. And neither of those, we found statistical significance. We also compared between groups on patient loneliness and boredom, meaning so by participating in the volunteer program, did it reduce their feeling of loneliness and boredom, which we did find statistical significance, indicating that by participating, it did reduce their feeling of loneliness and boredom on the weekend. We looked at to see if there were any correlations or if we could find any strong correlations between different factors within groups. Looking at if number of days per week they had friends and families come to visit affected their feeling of loneliness and boredom, we did not find a strong correlation here, or actually we found no correlation here. So just to review, 0 indicates that there's no correlation, 1 indicates strong correlation, and a negative number indicates a negative correlation. So we did not find correlation between number of days they have visitors with their feeling of loneliness and boredom. We didn't find any correlation between the age of the patient and their overall hospital satisfaction. And we also did not find correlation between age and their attitude toward participating in the program. So this just summarizes all of our findings, that we did find statistical significance of participation in the program with their feeling of loneliness and boredom. No correlations were found. And we did run a Wilkson signed ranks test to see within group differences of participating in the program more than one time, which we also found no significant difference for those patients that participated more than once in the program. Going back to those two qualitative questions or open-ended questions, the first one was, what were the good things about the weekend volunteer program? We were able to put this into 4 themes. One of them was student rapport with patients. So this was directly related to just building that relationship with the student, their personal and their professional behavior. The second was activities completed. The third was companionship, so just being able to have company or someone to talk to. And the last one was something different. This was referring to something different in the weekly routine, getting out of the room for a little bit. And as you can see, most patient responses were related to companionship, indicating that they just liked having someone to talk to or having that company on the weekend. The second question, or what ideas you have for improving the weekend program, we put into 3 themes. The first one was none, indicating that they had no ideas for improvement and they were satisfied with the program as is. The second was access to the program. So this was feedback relating to offering it more times a week, for longer bouts of time when they do interact with the students, or offering it to more patients. And the third one was the variety of activities offered. And you'll see that an overwhelming majority responded that they had no ideas for improvement, indicating that they were satisfied with the program as is. So what does all this mean? We found quantitative data to support that patients who participated in the Form with Others program were less bored or lonely on the weekend compared to those who did not participate. And although we did not find statistical significance for patient satisfaction of overall hospital stay, there is a positive relationship to support this. And then additionally, qualitative data does support our hypothesis that the weekend volunteer program can improve overall perceived satisfaction for patients in an inpatient rehabilitation hospital. So going back to the qualitative data, most of our respondents specifically on just the companionship or having someone to talk to on the weekends. We didn't find a correlation between age and satisfaction of the program, but we actually interpret this to be a positive finding in that we could target individuals of all ages. So we worked with patients ranging from age 23 all the way to 87, and showing that we can benefit all age groups. And then we didn't find a trend for participants who participated more than once in the program and overall satisfaction of the hospital stay, but this could be that we just had a small sample size. So we only had 3 patient participants that participated more than one time in the program. So going back to the quadruple aim and potential stakeholders, again, Sammy and I only looked at one piece of the puzzle. We just looked at how our program benefits or impacts patient satisfaction. But we are looking at, in the future, we're gonna look at how it can really impact all of these stakeholders. And currently, our mentors, Lou Jensen and Heather Knight, are looking at how it impacts students and how they might benefit from participating in this program as well. In the future, we'll look at how it might impact and benefit the clinical organization as well as the resident and the fellow. Some strengths of our research are that we had a large group, so we had statistical power and that we had more than 30 subjects participating. We also included a comparison group, or a control group for a comparison. Some limitations, we used a sample of convenience, just using patients receiving services at Emmanuel Rehab Hospital. And then based on or just the nature of the population we were working on, we worked with individuals that potentially might have cognitive deficits that impacts their ability to really fill out the survey to their fullest ability. So whether it's impaired memory, that they can't recall participating in the program by the time they go to fill out their survey, if they don't have a good understanding of what the questions are asking. And then just the survey itself, the questions may be a little misleading, not specifically stating, talking about the inpatient hospital stay, and patients might have been confusing that for previous hospital stays at like a different hospital setting. So in the future, again, we're gonna look at how it impacts those other stakeholders, but we also have discussed expanding our research to include maybe speech therapy students, as well as expanding it to participate in different hospital settings, such as acute care, maybe ICU, and seeing how the program can benefit patients in those type of settings. We also wanna use this initial data that we've collected to see how we can change our research surveys. So looking at length of stay to see if that can change, or if we can find any statistical significance with that type of information, as well as taking the diagnosis into consideration. So in the future, that's what we'll be looking at. And then I just want to give acknowledgments to Young Yud, who helped us significantly with our data analysis and making sense of interpreting all of our data. We could not have done it without him, as this was something that was relatively new for both Sammy and I. And then also acknowledging CHI Health and Emmanuel Medical Center for allowing this program to be implemented. Again, we couldn't have done it without them, and it benefits both students and the patients. So big thanks to them. And then now I will take any questions that you guys have. Or suggestions.
I have a question. How would you, learning what you've learned and kind of the mechanics and the logistics of you apply that to other settings like long-term care where there's often loneliness and things like that when people are in skilled nursing facilities for a long period of time?
Yeah, so Sammy and I didn't develop this program from scratch. It was something that the previous PT neuro resident developed last year, and then we carried it through to complete our research on it. But I would say in general, it takes a lot of, it was helpful that we're a community partner with CHI and we already have that relationship built. But then just really knowing your goals and having good communication and being on the same page with that community partner. I know for us, it took a lot of logistical planning in terms of how can these students be in here without supervision and all of that. So really just having a good plan before going in to implement this type of program. Does that answer your question?
Semi.
Okay. Okay.
Another follow-up is, did the students have the opportunity to give report back or something if they had observations on what was going on over the weekend? Can you talk about that?
Yeah, so I failed to mention that in the protocol, but they, after each engagement with the patients, we had one communication form. On Friday, the therapist communicated to us information to give to the students, and then on Sunday after their interaction with the patient, then they filled out that same communication form to give information back to the therapist. Just regarding participation or maybe how they set up their session, if you will, like if they were focusing on the left side, for example, or any communication type strategies, they could relay that onto the therapist.
What did you feel were some significant, like, good takeaways or not so good takeaways of having, like, you have OT and PT students, why not just OT or why not?
Sure, so at Creighton, in our school, we really emphasize that interprofessional collaboration. So that was always the plan from the start, is not only benefiting the patients receiving the service, but also how can we make another opportunity for these students to get interprofessional experience. So that was kind of like the whole foundation, a big part of the foundation of the program. Some good takeaways, we were able to do a debriefing. We went through two groups of students throughout the year, and we did a debrief after each volunteer group, and just seeing how much it positively impacted them, and then also hearing the patient perspective when you go in to work with them the next week and how much they benefit from it. So it was just really cool to see how it just anecdotally positively impacts everyone involved. So I don't think it's anything that we've formally talked about, but just I can answer maybe on the spot to why, what my thoughts are, is just the nature of the population in the setting we're in. It's really difficult to differentiate experience in the volunteer program versus their overall hospital stay. Like, the patients in general just don't know how they can really differentiate the two and respond appropriately. So I think that might make it difficult to do any type of assessment like that and seeing if their positive outcomes are specifically related to the program or just that they're improving in recovery. Also, my other thought is that, is that most patients only participate one time just because of the length of stay or family visiting, and so they didn't participate the second weekend or whatever. So tracking the outcome over a period of time is something that we have to figure out how we can increase that patient population or that group.
So how do you think this benefited you as a fellow, first year of practice, taking a big leadership role in research and service and coordination and all of those pieces of this program?
All of that.
What's that leading?
I was just reflecting on this the other day. Research was not my strong suit. by any stretch of imagination before coming into this, and just going through that process and having great mentors to learn the research process with, I feel a lot more comfortable not only completing survey-based research, but also presenting on it and really hashing out, like, what does this mean and how to interpret data. As far as leading the program, I learned that it takes a lot of communication and coordination and organization, all those good skills. And just even how you interact with students differently than maybe your therapy colleagues, and how you have to kind of tailor